Hi guys, welcome to another episode of Learn Technology in 5 Minutes by MakerDemi. This is NirmaL and I am part of the instructor team at MakerDemi. In this episode, we will learn about TinyML and see how it is going to be a breakthrough in embedded machine learning. So how do you think our phones always respond when you say OK Google, Hey Siri or Alexa, even when they are not connected to the internet? How are they continuously listening? Small neural networks of size as low as 14 kilobytes trained to detect these vague words are locally deployed on DSP chips in the phone, which only requires a few milliwatts of power to run instead of the phone's CPU, which utilizes more processing power. The term TinyML stands for Tiny Machine Learning. TinyML is an emerging technology to the public domain, but it is sure to gain traction within the next few years. It is essentially a field of study that lies at the intersection of embedded systems and machine learning that involves running complex models on ultra-low-powered microcontrollers. Though TinyML is relatively a new field, it has been in production for a long time by tech giants like Google, Apple, and Amazon, to name a few. Let us consider a case study. Plant Village, a research group from Pennsylvania, has developed a mobile app called Nuru AI that detects crop diseases in Africa. It runs machine learning models locally on the phone using Google's TensorFlow Lite platform. As it runs on the device, an internet connection is not required, which becomes helpful for farmers working in remote places. This is commonly referred to as edge computing. Before diving into TinyML, let us understand what edge computing is. Though IoT has revolutionized the usage of embedded devices, it is not always feasible to send sensor data to the cloud and then process it. It requires round-the-clock power and connectivity all the time. This is where edge computing comes into play. Edge devices are designed to handle specific tasks based on machine learning models without using cloud services. We make use of cheap 32-bit microcontrollers to run such ML models in the case of TinyML. Another important feature of deploying ML algorithms on the edge TinyML devices is that they can work on batteries for months or even years due to their low power consumption. Some of the simple ML applications that can be deployed on embedded systems are speech recognition, image recognition, and gesture detection using motion sensors. Imagine running an image recognition system on a microcontroller continuously for a year using a single coin battery. There are many benefits to using TinyML systems rather than IoT-based solutions because of their low power consumption, low latency, and inexpensive hardware. Also, they are a lot more secure as they are not connected to the cloud servers. There are about 250 billion embedded devices active right now, and it is estimated that there would be a growth of 20% per year. As the day progresses, it is becoming more difficult to process large amounts of data in the cloud. Thus, a shift towards TinyML devices could prove to be very effective. But only around 3 billion out of these 250 billion devices are currently able to support TinyML libraries. According to Pete Warden, the founder of the TinyML community, this technology has to be made accessible to developers so that mass deployment of inexpensive, independent, and less power-consuming microcontrollers for ML applications is possible. Such smart embedded systems can be implemented literally anywhere as they are not connected to the internet. Coming to the software for TinyML, the authors of the original TinyML book have modified the TensorFlow Lite framework to run on embedded systems that only require as small as 10 kilobytes of memory available. This open source release, known as TensorFlow Lite for microcontrollers, has several TinyML projects included as examples to get started with. Not many development boards can be used to implement TinyML as of now, but the most popular ones are the SparkFun Edge boards and the Arduino Nano 33 BLE Sense board. Also, Arduino has collaborated with Edge Impulse, a development platform that enables us to train, test, and deploy machine learning models on TinyML devices such as the Arduino Nano 33 BLE Sense and other low-power microcontrollers. For instance, machine learning models to detect gestures can be deployed in about 10 minutes of training. That is all, folks. If you like this video, smash the subscribe button and ring the bell to be updated about our future video releases.